So this video is for my friend Tim in New York, New York. Happy holidays, Tim. All right, so you were asking about groups and how to create a group. Well, first of all, go to the groups directory, and then you can just come over here to create a group. Now, the important things you're going to need to know about a group is LinkedIn likes it better when you have a logo. So if you don't have a logo, go ahead and create one in one of the free logo makers online. Later on, you can go ahead and get a more professional logo. And then acknowledge that that logo is actually yours. Really important in the group name, you're going to want it spelled out. So you are UMCLE, and let's see what that stands for here, because I don't know. Uniform Mandatory Continuing Legal Education. Yeah, that was easy. So you're going to want Uniform Mandatory Continuing Legal Education and then UMCLE, because that's probably how most people know it. So make sure you have that in the group name. Choose your group type. It might be an alumni, corporate, conference, networking, nonprofit, professional, or other. It's probably a professional group for you. Now, here in the summary section, you get 1,000 characters to describe your group and its purpose. Use your keywords, because if someone is looking for your group, but they don't know that they're looking for your group, they're just going to be typing in certain keywords. So you want to make sure those keywords are in your group. Now, most of you who have a website, and I notice that you do have a website here, go ahead and just pull the information from that. But think like your client. What would they be looking for if they were looking for a group like me? And go ahead and put those words in there. I'm sorry, that was in the description section down here. The summary is going to be, I believe it's 500 characters on what your description is about. So once again, use those keywords though, because it is heavily weighted. Put your website in there if you've got one. And if you are a group owner, you can put your email address down there. It doesn't have to be an email address associated with the group. Like, it doesn't have to be tim@umcle.com. It can be whatever you want it to be. Unlike a company, if you upload a company, you are going to have an email address at that company. Now, down here, give them open access. You don't want to have to limit the people who can join your group unless this is a group that is specifically for a defined group of people. So if it's an alumni group, or for instance, if UMCLE, that you only want UMCLE members to become part of it, then you can do request to join. Otherwise, just go ahead and do open access. Let people join it. You're going to want to do your language is English. Almost all the time. It's just a better way to go. You'll get more followers that way. You don't necessarily have to do a location or geographically based location, especially for a group like yours. And then you have to confirm that you are willing to do that. Now, once you've filled all that information in, you're going to have the ability, and let's see if I can go there, to invite people to your group. So let's see here, find a group, create a group. Oh, they've moved it on me. That's because I have to go in there first. So once you have your group together, under the overhead linkable links, whatever you want to call it right there, you can go to share group. And then once you hit share group, you can pick from all the people in your network that you are directly connected to, so all your number one connections. Now, what's kind of cool is if you're an industry-specific group, like Tim, you are legal, so you would just scroll down here, go to legal, and then just invite all those people to join your group. So boom, 17 people just like that. If you're geographically specific, then you might want to go by wherever you're living. So that's kind of cool too. You can choose those options to invite people. Now, the other thing is, once you have created your group, LinkedIn will give you a group URL. Now, it's going to be really awkward. Like, let's go into mine. So my group URL, boop-a-doo, let's go in here. I got to change my logo. So this is my group URL, not very user-friendly. So what I can do is take this, copy, paste, and then open up bit.ly, which is a URL shortener. I can put my long, bothersome LinkedIn URL there. I can now do, let's see, what is the name of my group? LinkedIn in Northern Colorado, and then Viv. So now my group has an easy to remember short URL. And once you have that, what's cool is you can email people and say, hey, join my group on LinkedIn. You can create subgroups for your group. So if you have, for instance, UMCLE California, UMCLE Atlanta, UMCLE Colorado, you could create subgroups for that. Once you've created your group, you can, of course, start a discussion, submit news. And what I highly recommend, oops, that's not where I wanted to go. What I would highly recommend is choosing your own updates as featured, because that will put them first. So anytime you do your own discussion in there, make it featured. If someone is a little bit too salesy, these are all pretty good. Here, this one's passed, so I can get rid of that. You can delete anything you want. So once again, you can follow a discussion, just like on Facebook or on Twitter. When you follow someone, you can actually follow a discussion in your group or any group you belong to, or you can follow an individual. You can make any discussion, whether it be your own or somebody else's, featured. If something looks like a job offer, you can move it to jobs. If you don't like it, you can delete it. If you're interested in the in what they're saying, then just add a comment. So that is basically how you're going to use groups. And once again, just remember to use those keywords. Oops, Daisy. Use those keywords in your summary and in your description. Your group isn't going to be very useful unless you can find it. And then shorten that really long, awkward URL that LinkedIn gives you using bit.ly or tinyurl or any of those other URL shorteners, and you're good to go. So I think I'm way past my 3-minute limit. I hope you found this helpful, Tim, and everybody else, and have a great day. Bye-bye.